ever seen a player whose stature or standing within the club was high enough that he could survive saying that to the gaffer in front of the bench and the other assistant coaches?
Well, I've seen it happen before. It's not the first time it's happened. When you're bottom of the league and you're searching for your first win and it's so clear that you're at fault, it wasn't a wise move. Sissé should have just put his head down straight to the tunnel, cop whatever was coming.
So Central Coast trying to find that first win, having come into tonight on the back of 8 straight losses and 14 losses in their last 16, at least got their nose in front so far. And who knows if and when the frustration will really kick in for Sydney FC that they can't breach this defence.
What Mulvey said, that they're not just going to sit back, because you know, quite often we see red card, 2 blocks of 4, sit deep. The Mariners look like they're still a little on the front foot. There are going to be periods when they are forced back. It depends on the quality of Sydney's play.
Sydney bench in the first half, thinking about potentially having to remove CM De Jong, but he continues on. Mariners, well, we see the Sydney bench there, so Anthony Caceres, Jacob Trapp, Cam Devlin and Luke Ivanovic, their outfielders. Mariners have the returning, belatedly, Tom Hiarie. Michael McGlinchey dropped out of the starting 11. Tommy Orr, who's on the comeback trail, and Mario Chabau. So safe to say that's a pretty attacking bench there. Really got too many defensive alternatives. Thus, Melling has been put into defence after the red card. Bit of a number chasing here. Brosk. Really dug in as he turned and spun it back to O'Neill. Zullo, a driven cross, dealt with by McGing. Ninkovic. Zullo. Well defended by Melling to turn it away.
He's been excellent tonight, Jacob Melling. A lot of defensive work.
Brillante. Lafondra. Players queuing up. De Jong. And the equaliser arrives from a very familiar source in Alex Ross.
CM De Jong kept the width, and that's what they need to do. And this is a good ball. He's just across the face of the box. He's hoping someone's there attacking the ball, and it's Brosk, and that is a clever, that's a class finish. Top draw finish from Alex Brosk. Slightly behind him, back heels it into the net. Perfect start to the second half for Sydney FC. And they drag them from one side of the pitch to the other, and De Jong kept his width, and that's the key for Sydney FC.
Now it presents the difficult question for Central Coast. Do they sit back on a draw? Do they try to consolidate a point? Otherwise, Kennedy's almost caught in possession by Brosk, and that would have been 2 goals in a minute.
Well, he's caught in possession, but he's lucky that he's sliding in Brosk, and you know, that can go anywhere, and he's lucky it goes out for a goal kick. Heavy touch there. First touch, and you can see he was worried as Brosk come hurtling in. Well, Brosk does like playing against Central Coast Mariners. Scored quite a few over the years.
It's number 11, and only Hassan Berisha and Archie Thompson have scored more against the Mariners.
It's a blow for the Mariners, because I'm sure Mike Mulvey impressed on his players, you know, not to concede early in the second half. Obviously, the longer it goes on, and you mentioned it, frustration for Sydney. They didn't have to wait too long.
The Cove now behind the goal that Sydney are attacking are going to be trying to suck that ball in and just invite on even more pressure, territory, possession. Central Coast, they do concede a second early here. Could be on a hiding to nothing. De Jong trying to make it happen for Lafondra. Flathead penalty. Mariners protest, but Sydney FC are on track for a quick fire double.
Well, De Jong's proved crucial, hasn't he? He sets up this, the VAR will be having a look at it. Lafondra with that little darting run down the inside right channel. Perfect weight on the pass. McGinn can't get there. I think Melling gets to the ball first, but does he get the man as well? The ball's still in play. Looks a penalty from that angle. And is it clear and obvious error? Well, Lafondra's foot's there as well.
There's one angle of all of those which maybe favours Melling, the others all tend to favour Lafondra. It's a tough one. When you talk about clear and obvious, it's hard to
overrule. Well, it's not clear and obvious error, so therefore it's a penalty.
Johnny Barrero has made that call.
And Lafondra has history in his sights.
Fast starting out of Lafondra, trying to hit double figures, quicker than anyone has reached the mark in the A-League. Turn this one around.
Well, Lafondra earns the penalty, gets up and he dispatches it. Kennedy goes the right way. And here's the challenge. So there goes Lafondra's foot. And that angle favours Melling. And that's the only one. But this one, Kennedy goes the right way, but it's too well struck. Lots of power. Dispatches it to the same side that the keeper goes. Brilliantly executed penalty, but that angle makes it a contentious one.
There it is, 10 snags, Adam Lafondra. And he edges out Bruno Fornaroli by a single game, getting to that mark the quickest, just his 11th A-League appearance. Came here with the promise of goals. So far, so good for Sydney. Now the Mariners down a player. To show a lot of enterprise to get anything out of this match. Of course, Sydney are 2 goals away from going top of the league tonight. They win by 3 clear goals. They'll leapfrog both Perth Glory and Melbourne Victory to take top spot before the rest of the A-League weekend shakes out. I'm sure that Glory and Victory fans would have been quite enjoying that first half, but not so much. Fonda is offside on this occasion. It's a light ball at the feet of Kennedy. Had his arms outstretched, wondering if it was or not. Had to react quickly. He's already been caught in possession once by Brosk in this half.
So if we look, this is camera 6 gets the perfect angle. He clearly gets the ball. Lafondra doesn't dive. It's the momentum of Melling that takes him over as well, but it's not clear and obvious error. But Melling clearly got the ball first.
It's a tough one. But
put it this way, if he doesn't give it and it goes to the VAR, they wouldn't have given it.
Correct. That'll be cold comfort to Mariners fans. As they now trail and are seemingly at the mercy of Sydney FC. Holding up, and Lafondra was coming from a long way back, but made ground.
Yeah, well done, Ben Kennedy. Made the decision to come, came with authority, and the ball just had a little bit too much on it from Minkovic.
Down the line. Referee's perhaps made the right call there. Central Coast take the free kick quickly. Simon perhaps trying to buy a yellow card rather than actually use the ball. Oh. It's up to circumstances of the night are now starting to get in Central Coast heads. Now preparing a substitution, Mario Chabau is at the sideline. Ninkovic. The cross from Retre is deflected. De Jong. Out hustled by Hall. He goes and commits a foul. And that will prompt the first sub.
So poor cross from Retre. He had plenty of time to provide a good delivery. So we've got another angle for the pen. This is this one. Now that one suggests that he's hitting this contact on the leg before he gets to the ball.
So his left leg takes out Lafondre.
So there you go. I think the point to make is it's not clear and obvious. Whenever we're going to overturn it.
Now Matt Simon, who talked his way into the book in the first half, clearly showing a lot of frustration. Mike Mulvey is perhaps short-circuited this evening. There's an ovation for him from the Sydney FC fans as he comes up.
Yeah, why wouldn't it be? A successful stint. Graham Arnold brought into the club. He did a really good job for Sydney FC.
Well, that says it all. Insubordination and dissent. Mariners bench not for the first time tonight. Chabau has come on, so here's an attacker for an attacker. The other end of the pitch, though, is where the Mariners are going to have the most work to do, because Broska's in again, and he's denied once, but not a second time. Free scoring Sydney, starting to run away with this one, and Alex Broska has a double.
Well, they get caught out on the left-hand side, the ball didn't go out. Retre, one pass after it was onto Lafondre. Lafondre had Broska by himself, but he had to make a bit of space, and he does. He drops the shoulder, looks up, picks out Broska, should have scored first time. Good save from Kennedy, but he reacts very quickly, Alex Broska, and the right-footed volley into the back of the net. And Broska got himself a double, and they're getting torn apart now.
Up to five for the season now, Alex Broska. 3-1. We are not quite at the hour mark. I'm just teeing up the PDF, Robbie, with the record margins between these two teams. Just leaving it there. We may need to refer to it if we see too many more passes like that in the Mariners' back four. We're not there yet, but just flagging that it could get ugly if Sydney really want to go on with the job. It's this Mariners team that started the night with so much positivity and so much energy and took the lead, and now attacking meaningfully, really, for the first time in this second half. Payne. Cool. Back to Payne. He's got one tonight. That won't be his second.
Didn't have time to let it come across his body enough to set himself for the strike. Movement from combination from Payne and Hull.
Saw the high five there between Mike Mulvey and Tommy Orr. So turning to the bench is the Central Coast coach. Orr's come back from injury.
Yeah, Tommy Orr's probably thinking, wow, yeah, it would have been nice to get a different kind of comeback.
And then the burning question will be, will we see Tom Hiarie at any point? Sprightliness off the back of conceding the third. Calvert is going to have to use his wits to clear here. Gave away the ball. Orr. Not Orr. Payne. My apologies. Orr's on the the mind because
he'll be out there soon.
He's walking up to the sideline right now. And he will be replacing Connor Payne. So the Central Coast goal scorer.
Yeah, he's not happy, Connor Payne. And I can tell you now, each Mariner that comes off, and that's smart, he's not spitting the dummy there, he's just allowing the substitution to be made. But every Mariner that comes off and is not happy, they've got one man to blame, and that's their big experienced central defender, Sisse. And the trouble, what happened to the Mariners is they didn't hold on for long enough. They conceded straight after half-time. Second one soon followed. So, that frustration that might have been there for Sydney never transpired.
Zullo, Lafondra, Ross got a hat-trick. Leaves Hall with a little grab that advantage is given for. Lafondra now.
He's having some game, Alex Brosk. When you think Alex Brosk was never supposed to play the big part he's playing this season, that injury to Trent Bahaja saw him become a starter, I think. It's lucky Brandon O'Neill, it's lucky Wilkinson was on the front foot.
Ninkovic, oh, clever back heel, releases Zullo. Sydney are in behind. Zullo, and he misses both.
He should have shot by himself. He should have taken on himself. If he's going to play that ball, probably a little bit softer. I'm not so sure he wasn't shooting.
Brosk and Lafondra to aim for, and the target as well.
What about the... he makes it look so simple, Ninkovic, to release Zullo.
It's not just the pass, it's the timing to hit Zullo in stride like that. Off and chasing, can't do much about it.
Brilliant awareness, balance. This one, no, he's crossing it. Brosh just missed it, to be fair, this is below.
Mike Mulvey has been booked by Johnny Barrero, who ran across the pitch to show him the yellow card. Goes from bad to worse for the Central Coast Gapper. Opening up gaps, Brosk, is this the hat-trick for him? Steadies, chips, gorgeous! Sydney running away into the distance. Alex Brosk, unbelievable goal. The presence of mind to chip it in and round out his hat-trick.
And I think Sian Dion gets another assist through the middle. Lafondra misses it. And what about this from Brosk? He doesn't have the pace like he used to. In years gone by, he would have taken another touch, his pace would have taken him away. But what about the composure and the skill to chip this over the advancing Ben Kennedy? There's no blame on the goalkeeper. It's just a wonderful goal from a wonderful player.
Years old, he's doubled his season tally in a single night. Goals are coming so thick and fast. The scoreboard operator is struggling to keep up here at Jubilee Stadium. Alex Brosk up to 73 total A-League goals off the back of tonight's treble. And it has come in rapid time, 49, 58, 64. And the night is young. It is 4-1, Sydney atop of the live table as things stand. Here tries to provide some resistance for the Central Coast. He's closed down in a one-on-two. And Sydney look irresistible every time they go forward now. Hands. When he left the game, it was 1-0. favour of that team, the Central Coast Mariners. Now, it is an all too familiar feeling there on the bench. Those faces say it all, really. The record books beckon here for all the wrong reasons for the Central Coast. Tonight's going to be 9 losses in a row. The New Zealand Knights sit at 11. Miller. Can they get a second here? They can! Aidan O'Neill means the Mariners have pegged 1 goal back. And what is becoming a shootout delivers its 6th goal by just the 66th minute.
Well, Miller does superb. That's as much his goal as O'Neill, with a really good finish, you must say. And they didn't track O'Neill's run. Miller nice and strong on Zulu, and then he's direct. But he's got the awareness to pick out the run of O'Neill. And they didn't track him. I think it's De Jong tracking O'Neill, but he gets there first. And a really good finish.
The back of the net, just his second A-League goal, and it's Mariners' second tonight. That, if nothing else, will affect the table. Up Sydney FC, back down a little. Turn to the bench, Robbie, at this busy time of the year with a calendar full of games. Is there anyone you particularly want to see or would want to rest?
Well, I think Caceres is an obvious one to get some minutes into it.
We'll be on again here, Sydney. Ninkovic, it's going to sit up.
Ninkovic just delayed too long. And then Lafondra wouldn't sit for him. Desperate defending, and they clear it. He's one-on-one with Redmayne. He's had some chances tonight, Ninkovic.
Zulu. Ninkovic has missed out. It's almost like the batsman who gets out early on a good wicket, and the rest of the scorecard goes on to make runs.
Now, come on, Tia. We're not going to talk cricket, surely, after today. 622,
was it? It was enough. It's not quite a cricket score here. In fact, the Mariners, if they were to score one back, Sydney would probably have a few recriminations as to how they've copped 2 goals in a game where they've had it so much on their terms. Of course, it would be the third of the night, but since the red card, it would have been the second goal. For now, though, it is just the one, a one-off, perhaps. Central Coast focused still very much on defending rather than attacking. McGinn gets it away. Ninkovic. Great reach for the ball, but then couldn't keep it at ground level. Matt Miller, still full of running. And a nutmeg. Goes past Brandon O'Neill. It's a great individual effort here from Matt Miller. And it nearly turned into an assist for Jordan Murray.
Really good play again from Miller. He's done Zulu again. And a little nutmeg on O'Neill. And I'll tell you, that touch from Calver was important. Not sure why they took a short corner there. We thought set piece a pretty good option to get another goal. They end up back on their own halfway line. That's a poor decision.
They have retained the ball. Tommy Orr unable to find a way through. Brandon O'Neill.
It's the danger when they pull forward, they're going to leave themselves open.
Ninkovic to Brosk. Again. Sends Lafondra wide, and the legs were motoring after it from Adam Lafondra.
Just about got there, didn't he?
Right. Sydney readying a double sub. The Mariners are able to withstand this attack. You are going to see Caceres, Robbie. He's one of the two waiting in the wings. tipped off here. The Mariners just to get a breather on the ball. Now the changes. Jacob Trout is the other player that will come on. Being replaced here is Siem Dyong. Crunched twice in the first half. The first of which was the second booking for Khalifa Cissé.
What? Well, it's a pretty good evening for Siem Dyong. There's doubts over when he got clattered. Matt Simon got booked, got a heavy knock, and he's continued on. He's finished with three assists and a secondary assist. And the impressive thing with his assists were they're all a mixed bag. One, the little ball from the darting run from Laponga from the penalty one, then he smacked across the face of the goal that Ross scored with his first goal, the equaliser, the backheel. And the other one was a terrific dissecting through ball for Bros third. And his secondary assist was the one where he plays in Lafondre, who crosses for Bros's second goal.
Pretty good night's work then. Now the change is Paolo Retre coming off for Jacob Trout.
Yeah, sorry about that, Tia.
No, I'm just happy to hear it. And so Anthony Caceres at his latest club. This is A-League appearance number 106. With him relocating to Sydney, unfortunately means one of the power couples of Australian football has been broken up because his wife, Helen Caceres, remains in Melbourne City. I'm sure watching on TV. Through traffic. Tommy Orr backtracking. Melling. An ambitious crossfield pass proves to be exactly that. Ninkovic. Brandon O'Neill to Brosk. Tom Hiarier, the number six, walking up to the sideline to, at last, belatedly get some minutes at the Central Coast. So you don't want to fall asleep at the wheel here. It is 4-2. They would give up a goal via a sloppy back pass or a defensive lapse. All of a sudden, it's a one-goal game. So forward is the go, and a foul from Poole. Last action of the game. All the Sydney FC players not quite outlived the memories of a few of the Boo Boys, but only a smattered few. And Tom Hiarier, been waiting a while for A-League appearance number 5 this season, but here it is with 15 to go. Thank you. the attack. And the offside flag was raised. Mariners playing themselves into trouble. Chabal is going to combine with Aidan O'Neill and try to work them forward. Took on by Lafondra. To Zulu. Brillante. To Brosk. Nikovic. Matt Miller defending his right back corner. Nikovic. A little bit stationary ahead of the ball at the moment. Brillante. Turned by Lafondra, but fresh legs of Tommy Orr were able to steal in between he and the ball. Sent Matt Miller down the line. Still offered by Calvert.
Well, he's got two on him and made it difficult. He's tried hard, hasn't he, Matthew Miller? And added with a bit of quality as well. Such a forceful, physical player.
Introduction.
Oh, he's got better options. He's got Trent to his right, and I'm pretty sure Lafondra with the little ball down the inside right channel. Goes for glory. Important time for Caceres. It really is a player with so much talent. His career just hasn't taken off as many thought it was going to.
There is a place to showcase what he can do. Sydney FC, not a bad one. How quickly he can integrate himself into the squad. Perhaps even trying to make himself a starting 11 player, an undroppable option. Might be involved here though. Melling to Murray. Passes behind Chabal, and they're not on the same wavelength as Miller. Is read well by Redmayne. Brillante. Brandon O'Neill.
Ready! Stay on your feet!
Acceleration comes and draws a foul and a card.
Well, he got two, didn't he? Got one, he managed to carry on. The second one draws the card. Great feat to avoid the first one. O'Neill with a real hack.
Early clear-cut yellow card for Brandon O'Neill, and thus no complaints as a result. And the home fans are going to get the chance to give a standing ovation. The end of a first A-League hat-trick for Alex Bross. Up to six goals for the A-League season, doubling his tally tonight alone.
Well, Alex Bross rolled back the years this evening. And he's given us a masterclass.
A treble coming in the space of 15 match minutes, also included, as we see almost a fifth. Good save. Kennedy has denied Tratt from scoring again. In fact, has that bounced over without a touch?
No, it's offside. He's given a offside, so I wouldn't have counted. So we got to give Ben Kennedy credit because it was a terrific save.
The three Bros goals also coming with the Lafondra penalty in between. So quite the surge from Sydney FC to put themselves 4-1 at the time. Lafondra's goal coming from the penalty spot, a penalty that he won. Mariners have since pegged one back. Sydney have now emptied the bench with young Luke Jovanovic coming on. Is concerned in these final 7.5 minutes because again Sydney are one goal away from top spot. Perth Glory have returned to the top of the league. Miller has lowered his colours tonight. Because it's the Mariners who've shown faith to him and thrown him an A-League lifeline more than 2 years after he was one appearance and then out of Melbourne City. But Matt Miller, these appearances are just going to put him in the shop window, or in the released and then immediately picked up on a free transfer window for a different A-League team. If the opportunity came, could you begrudge him for wanting to move to a different club?
Look, in this kind of situation, of course it's about the team, but it's also, when times are tough like this, it's about looking after your own individual performance, and he's certainly doing that.
Lafondra, the early ball will arrive with Sulu, denied, and Ivanovic ran beyond the ball.
Good save, brilliant ball, break from Lafondra, Sulu just went for pure power. A good save from Ben Kennedy. Now one on the follow-up for Sydney.
Zulu.
lead, pulls away from Pereira. There he looks up. He's missed it by quite some distance, but he's trying to bend it into the far post. Doable. He's got it in his locker, but he's had a good game. Class.
I've got to say, looking at that
Ninkovic, but he's had five chances.
That angle from behind the strike. It's Milos Ninkovic. You almost expect that the bend would have been there on the shot. Still also going at breakneck speed as he tried to steady. Pull the trigger. This season, though, Milos Ninkovic. I feel like when he does hit the back of the net, it might just be something special to make it worth the wait. Miller. Chabau. Pierre. Second time of asking, he just scuffed the ball. Now Ivanovic. It's good balance from the youngster. Rides the challenge. Now he can show his fleet-footedness. Laying it off for Lafondra. And Ivanovic! No. What not to be.
Great break from the boy. Positive and makes the right decision to Lafondra. Lafondra can't get his shot off and he lays it back and he's just maybe seen the glory before. Maybe a bobble as well, but he couldn't hit it cleanly. Sort of rather snatched at it. Big chance for him.
Unselfish from Lafondra, and Ivanovic, just 18 years old, in A-League appearance number 3. Nearly had a debut goal in front of the Cove.
Keep going, Jake! Keep going, Jake!
2 minutes of regulation to go. Lafondra on the tight angle, buys a corner.
Credit Jacob Melling. We talked about Miller, but Melling's not given up anything this evening. He was superb in, before the red card in the middle of midfield. Him and Aidan O'Neill were winning that battle, taking deservedly the lead, but he's not given up all night.
Perhaps a drink here as the Mariners prepare to defend. Corner number 5. After 1 for the evening. A bit of semantics about standing back from where the corner is to be taken. We'll take us into stoppage time. Caceres. Brillante. A little drifter. And number 5! Aaron Calder!
What a finish. What a volley from Aaron Calder.
His first A-League goal, and it's going to round out a special night for Sydney FC, as that should take them top of the league.
Well, Brillante, the short corner, he had a shot, if you remember, the first time he received the ball in that area. This time he picks out Calver at the back post, and this is deliberate. Brilliant technique on the volley from Aaron Calver. No chance for Kennedy. That's a bullet. Technically perfect, the volley. Floated over, keeps his eyes on it. He's made his mind up already. Over the head of the defender. And what a brilliant finish from Aaron Calver.
Five additional minutes until the Mariners can get on the road and go back to licking their wounds, contemplating yet more upheaval, as Khalifa Cisse, of course, will be suspended for their next match.
The only, there'll be a decision from Mike Mulvey he'll have to make, because he's disrespected the coaching staff in front of the whole bench, in fact in front of the nation.
Ivanovic showing some real flashes so far tonight. Sydney aren't done yet. Well, Lafondra's going to have to chase this down. Gives the Mariners a chance to get back in position. Zullo. Ivanovic, crowd want him to shoot. He does, deflected. They want Brillante to shoot as well, and he bends that harmlessly into the arms of Kennedy.
We know he can hit him. They've just won in this second half, and from that distance, you have to hit it with power. And he just didn't have time because they were closing him down.
Tell you what, Aaron Calvert, you said the technique, Robbie, game number 36 in the A-League. He's not going to forget that goal in a hurry. Pretty neat way to do it. Now over the top, flag is up. And Lafondra just showing off there. Little loop into the back of the net.
Fastest player, Adam Lafondra, to 10 goals.
How many in the offing? 27 game home and away season. Can he hit a mark like
Bobo-esque?
25?
What did Bobo hit last season? 27? He'd probably be a little bit disappointed. He's got himself at least a double here.
He's too unselfish. He gave the chance to Ivanovic. Primarily gone to a man who hasn't scored. It's Ninkovic, who's been perhaps the most prominent. It's even with the night that Alex Brost netted himself a hat-trick. Mariners have got a late corner here. If nothing else, this does matter to Perth Glory. Sydney have again dislodged them at the top of the league. Brisbane Roar on Sunday. Tommy Orr's corner. Dealt with by Redmayne. Here, Jubilee Stadium, Sydney FC 5, Central Coast Mariners 2. Ross will keep the match ball, but a first A-League goal for Aaron Cook.